This is the next question we have. It says, the element with Z equal to 120 not yet discovered will be N or A. Options are inert transition metal, alkaline earth metal or alkali metal. This is a very simple question. Students, we know 118 element. This 118th element will belong to 18th group. So, 119th element will belong to group 1 and 120th element will belong to group 2. Group 2 is an alkaline earth metal. So, the element with Z is equals to 120 will be an alkaline earth metal. Hence, the correct answer for this question will be option 3. Now, let's move to the next question. This is the next question we have. It says, freezing point of a 4% aqueous solution of X is equals to freezing point of 12% aqueous solution of Y. If molecular weight of X is A, then molecular weight of Y is. Students, here these percentages are given. We have to assume these are weight by volume percentage because no information is given, no density is given. So, we are assuming it as weight by volume percentage and molarity is equals to molality. So, in that condition, what will happen? The molarity of both the solutions should be same. Or if I talk about the number of moles of solute in both the solution should be same, assuming 100 ml of solution. So, we can simply write that number of moles of X should be equal to number of moles of Y, assuming 100 ml of solution. So, number of moles of X will be equal to 4 by molar mass of X. This is equals to 12 by molar mass of Y. So, from here we can write that molar mass of Y is equals to 3 times of molar mass of X. It's given that molar mass of X is given A. So, this will be 3 times of A. So, the molecular mass of Y or molar mass of Y will be 3A. So, the correct answer for this question will be option 2. Now, let's move to the next question. This is the next question we have. It says 50 ml of 0.5 molar oxalic acid is needed to neutralize 25 ml of sodium hydroxide. The amount of sodium hydroxide in 50 ml of the given sodium hydroxide solution is. So, students, if I talk about this question, here we have 50 ml of 0.5 molar oxalic acid. So, we can equate equivalence of acid is equals to equivalence of base. So, 50 into 0.5 into its N factor equal to 2 is equals to molarity of sodium hydroxide into its N factor 1 and volume 25. So, from here we have molarity is equals to 2 mole per liter. So, the amount of sodium hydroxide in 50 ml of the given sodium hydroxide solution is? First of all, we will find the number of moles of sodium hydroxide. It is 2 into 50 by 1000, which is 0.1 mole. So, weight of sodium hydroxide will be equal to number of moles into molar mass. So, this is 4 gram. Now, if I go through the options, there is no option which is correct answer. So, this will be a bonus question. Now, these are the questions which were asked in 12th January 2019 JEE Mains morning session paper. This is all for this session. Thank you.